And now everyone else is following suit. You get
a superstar. The only way you get a Sugar Ray Leonard, a Muhammad Ali. The cult of personality that comes around those people, they do have all the power. There's no getting around
that.
They do. You can't stop that as a promotional organization. You have to somehow or another ride with the wave and make some sort of cohesive agreement.
They also have to be challenged.
You got
to
make some sort of agreement with that person. That's the only way you get Mike Tyson.
They made it with Brock Lesnar. They made it with Ronda Rousey. The only other two superstars.
Right.
But they didn't last because what keeps a champion relevant and in the lore is the guy who keeps answering the call. And Conor did that in two different weight classes. I mean, he beat the impossible to beat Jose Aldo, and then people are going to argue that because he hasn't defended a belt. Right, and what
so
I'm saying is that,
the belt.
That's what I'm saying. That's why I agree with your point about the evolution of the combat sport. What it's done now is put so much power in his hands. He's got $100 million, whatever he has.
Which I love.
And me too, because I like the guy, but at the same time, You're not going to see him fight these monsters like Tony. You're going to see him fight Tony this year.
Why would you say that? First of all, I don't like anybody saying this guy's not going to do this or he's not going to do that, because we really don't know. But why wouldn't he fight Tony Ferguson if he wants to fight again?
I haven't seen him even training. I don't know.
He's training nonstop.
Do you follow him on Instagram?
Oh, Bryan.
No.
You can't say that.
But is he going to fight Tony Ferguson?
He hasn't come to my house. He hasn't been training in Santa Monica.
Well, that's the problem.
Where are you going to see him train?
Has he even mentioned fighting Tony Ferguson?
Yes. If he pays attention, he goes, my next fight. They talk to each other back and forth.
TMZ
goes, hey, are you going to box Pacquiao? He goes, no, my next fight is mixed martial arts. I'm going to fight inside that octagon.
Yeah, he said my next fight is going to be a real fight. No boxing.
He's going to fight Tony Ferguson. That Tony Ferguson fight, when I look at it more and more, I watch footage, I think it's not that bad of a matchup for Conor. I used to be like, God, it's a tough fight. But I think especially early rounds 1 through 3, with Conor's accuracy and the way Tony gets hit, it's a good fight for Conor. Except when it goes past the third round, it could get nasty.
Yeah. Two parts of the problem. One, Tony finishes motherfuckers off his back. He is nasty off his back.
If he gets taken down.
Yeah, he doesn't get tired. But I'm saying if he gets hit like Nate Diaz does and goes down, like Conor is not, it's not like 100% that he's going to beat him up and ground and pound him. Tony, if he gets dropped, will wrap you up like a fucking mummy and submit you.
So he can do that. And Conor doesn't entertain that.
Maybe Nate, yeah.
You know
Nate
what I'm saying?
Can.
Like, he doesn't
Nate,
have to
Nate
play
certainly
that game.
Can.
The difference is if Tony goes, you know what? I know you're fast and powerful in these first three rounds. I'm a collegiate wrestler. Fuck this noise. I'm just going to ankle pick you all fucking day.
It's true.
And then third, fourth, fifth, I'm going to start striking with you.
But Conor could catch him
before
that. Yeah. Conor
it's
has
a good fight.
Ridiculous speed.
Tony doesn't get
speed
tired.
And
I haven't seen him get tired.
It's a big difference.
He's tired. He doesn't show it because he's a fucking serial killer.
I think he gets less tired than the other guy.
I promise you he gets tired, Bryan.
But everybody gets tired.
No, it's just here for him.
But it is. But he also is ridiculous conditioning.
Amazing.
You know, Eddie Bravo is his fucking jiu-jitsu trainer. And Eddie said he's never seen anything like this guy.
Yeah.
He said the guy trains for 6 hours a day.
Yeah.
He said he's in Big Bear. He's running hills, literally lapping his training partners.
Yeah. He'll
turn
with
around and
rain.
Go back and run
I
up again. They're not even up to the top of the hill yet.
That is such an advantage in a 5-round fight. I mean, such an advantage in a 3-round fight. I mean, his ability to just not, like, when you're less tired than the other guy, oh my God.
All his camps are at Big Bear. He goes, he rents a house. He builds his own fucking training facility. He sets up his own heavy bags. He mats up floors. He takes a fucking room. He's got like a living room of a house. He sets down the borders, brings in the mats, and they start training. He finds hills, runs those fucking hills at 6,000 feet altitude. God, he's an animal.
Conor at 55 is no punk, man.
He's not.
No punk. Ask Eddie Alvarez. Look at Eddie.
Oh,
yeah. Now he's a fucking
nobody
monster.
Says he's a punk. Man.
No, I'm just saying. Like, I mean, at first I was like, God, this guy's a scary fight for Conor. Then when I look at him, like, you know, he does get hit. Ferguson gets hit, man.
Yes.
The problem child is Khabib. It's almost a round table because Khabib versus Tony, hell of a fight. Khabib versus Conor, God, that's a tough fight for Conor. Yeah. But they can eliminate each other. It's whoever shows up that night. It's a fucking good fight, man.
Yeah,
dude, if Khabib
takes your legs down.
We're going to know all about Khabib this weekend. When he fights Edson Barboza, we're going to see him with arguably the fastest striker in the 155-pound division.
Who doesn't give a fuck about going to the ground. He's like, no, we're not going to the ground. I'm not even entertaining that. Yeah. Where other guys will play that game,
right?
Anti-wrestling will kick you in the fucking face.
Right, but how do you keep him from taking you to the ground
you
when he clinches?
You kick him in the face.
When he gets in the clinch.
you avoid the clinch.
Yeah, how do you avoid that with Khabib, though?
It's hard. It's fucking hard. It's not an easy fight by any stretch of the imagination.
It's
but
a tough
you
fight for Khabib.
Michael Johnson cracked Khabib when they fought and had him wobbly. It's the first time we've seen any adversity that Khabib had to face inside the octagon. Yeah. But he handled it with fucking four aces. Took him to the ground.
I had no idea Khabib went up to 205 when he trains. Like,
well, he gets heavy. He gets heavy in between fights, but he didn't do it this time.
No.
Daniel Cormier said he has a new nutrition, and he said he has been lighter getting ready for this camp than any fight before. He was 179 pounds just a couple of weeks ago.
Josh Thompson was like, dude, you've never seen anything like it. Because I was talking about Conor and Khabib. He's like, dude, I'm telling you, man. I've seen him go with DC. I've seen him go all these guys. And think about what he did to Dos Anjos. Think about what he did.
Ragdolled him.
Ragdolled him.
So ragdolls like, everybody.
Oh, you're fighting at 70? And I go, why doesn't Khabib just go to 70 after he sees what
Dos
Anjos? He's going to.
He is? That's his plan.
All he wants to do is get the belt at 55. Okay. As soon as he gets that, he's going, peace. And then at 70... Enjoy that.
Yeah.
Enjoy that motherfucker at 70.
It's like he gets you and he breaks your legs down. It's like, oh, you're a table. I'm going to take your legs down. Now you're on the ground and that's it.
Well,
I've never seen anybody get him off.
All elite wrestlers, right? Whether you're talking about Dave Schultz or whether you're talking about, Karellen. All the best of the best wrestlers, they have an ability to enforce their will.
Yeah.
To just power into guys and do shit to them that they don't want done and break them.
They wear you. They wear you like
with technique, with will, with physical conditioning, with everything.
Yeah.
DC's the same way. All the best guys have everything. Yeah. They have all the components. And that's one of the things Nurmagomedov does. Then you add the fact that he's from Dagestan. You add the fact that he grew up in one of the hardest places in the fucking world.
That's right.
And everyone around him is hard as nails.
Where I think the national sport might be wrestling.
Might be murder.
Yeah.
Get a varsity in murder in high school.
Varsity murder.
It's a crazy place,
What's
man.
What's ridiculous is him versus Barboza, if it's like a video game, you look at their attributes, Barboza's striking's like this, but his wrestling's like this.
Yep.
Then you look at Khabib, his wrestling's like this, but striking's
so
like
you,
this.
So you're intrigued by this.
Fuck yeah. This to me is the most intriguing fight that Khabib has ever fought.
By far.
Two reasons.
Yeah.
One, the two fights where he had so much difficulty making weight that his body was shutting down. It happened in the Michael Johnson fight. Then it happened again in the Tony Ferguson fight, the point they pulled him off the card.
So they were saying
his liver was shutting down. Like, this is serious, serious shit.
Yeah.
He has not made 155 since, right? He hasn't fought since. So there's so much pressure on him to do this correctly. But who knows if he can? When your body does not want to do that anymore, you run into serious problems. It's one of the things that happens to older athletes when they've been cutting extreme amounts of weight over and over again. They get to a point where their body is every time you cut 30 pounds of water from your body goes into like a state of shock.
Sure.
You do some damage. The question is, how much damage are you doing?
Well, think how long he's been doing it, too. Josh Thompson brought that point. He goes, dude, he's been cutting weight since he was a kid.
Yeah.
Like, he's been in these wrestling terms, the sambo terms, since he was a kid. So he's older now. He's been cutting weight for fucking ever.
And here's a real question.
He hasn't fought
forever. If he wins the title, how the fuck is he going to defend it in California?